Today I'm going to be showing you a simple way to get started using the KineMaster editing tool for your phone. Let's jump in. Now this is a really powerful tool that has a lot of capabilities that are built into it. There is a free version to get started. There's also a paid version which unlocks some other features, and I'll talk about that as I go. So first you just want to search for KineMaster in your wherever you get your apps, download that. It'll walk you through the process, and there's actually nothing that you need to do if you're on the free version to sign up. You don't need to give them any of your information in the first go around. And I will also include a link in the description so you can download it directly from that link. And when you open up the dashboard, it'll look just like this. And all we want to do is we're going to go to Create New right there at the top. And then from here, the first thing you want to do is you just want to add the name. So I'm going to call this my vlog. And then you have a couple of preset options in here. You could use it to create a video for YouTube or TikTok, Instagram, some format aspect ratio options. So I'm going to just click on the YouTube video here and create. And you see once that opens up, it changes the orientation of your phone to the wide format. So it's a little bit easier to see everything in there. A couple of things on the navigation here. Over in the top right-hand corner, you can see a big circle menu. This is where you add media or new layers or audio elements, things like that. To the left of that is kind of a preview window of everything that you see in your timeline. And then below that is the timeline, which shows you all of your clips in how they're going to be laid out in the video. And then there's some other options over on the left-hand side to undo something you just did or change some of the settings and things like that. So we're just going to start by adding some clips in here. And so you just go up to the menu. That'll take you to what you have on your phone. And then you can see up here the videos that you have on your phone. And you just want to click the videos that you want to add to this. So I'm just going to grab a couple here. Just like that. I'll take that one. Okay. Then you close out of that. Now you can see all the clips that you just added are added to the timeline in the order that you clicked on them. Now what you can do is you can kind of pinch into that timeline to zoom into it a little bit. This doesn't change out of the editing or the speed or anything like that. It just allows you to see more of the timeline on the screen. So I like to be able to see everything kind of laid out that way. And you can kind of scrub back and forth and see what that looks like, or you can hit the little arrow button here to play it back. And so you can play it back that way. We'll just hit pause. So let's talk a little bit about some basic editing. One, you could change the order of the clips if you just press and hold on the clip, and then you could slide it over. Let's say I want that one to be at the beginning, and you can move them around that way. The other thing you can do is if you click on the clip, now you see these yellow bars at the beginning and end. And you could slide those over to shorten the clip. Now this is editing it, so that's where the clip's going to start. And then we have the clip ending there. Maybe I want to do the same thing over here. So you can drag those yellow bars in to adjust where the clip begins and ends. And you see it drags everything with it. Now on the next clip, I'm going to go over here. And you can see if I just slide my finger back and forth, the playhead will move with it. So I can pick exactly where I want it to end. Let's say I want to chop off that last part. So another way to do that is you can go trim and split. If I click on that, it'll give you some options. It'll trim everything to the left of the clip, or it'll trim everything to the right of the clip, or you can split it right down the middle. What I want to do is I want to trim everything at the right. That's the ending of the clip. I want to trim everything off there. So you just clip on that and then it pops that over. Now another option is let's say we want to use half of this. So we go to that point and I just want to split that into two clips. We could hit split and now I have two separate clips. And now I could take this one and drag that before me talking and drop it in there like that. So now we have this clip going. So now we have me talking between that split of that clip. Okay. And while you have that clip selected, you can see plenty of other options of things that you could do, that you could change the speed, meaning it goes faster or slower. You could reverse the footage. You could pan and zoom across the video. A lot of options there based on what you need it to do. Okay. Now we're going to back out of that. All right. So this is looking pretty good. Now, what I want to do is I want to add some text to this. So we're going to go over to the layers. We're going to add text. And let's say I want to add my name. So I'm going to type that in, click OK. And you see now it adds this bar down here at the bottom, which is over top of the footage of my name. So you see it adds my name there into a separate layer. So that's completely independent of the footage. And now over on the side, we have some options. We could change the font. Let me go to, let me use the Bradley handwriting. Click OK. Let's change the color. Let's do like a light blue. You can even add like an in animation to have it fade up. We could add an out animation to, let's say we want it to slide down. Then what we can do with our finger is click on the text in the preview monitor and slide it around the screen so we can put it right where we want it. So we'll put it over here, over the trees. And you could scroll through here. I mean, you could add outlines, you could add shadows. Maybe I'll add a little shadow. That might be nice. So we'll enable that. And you can increase it. Maybe we want to make it a little darker. So you click on the color, change the angle. I mean, everything is so customizable in this. Adjust the spread. There you go. So we're going to pop out of that. Now we down on the timeline. I just want to click on that layer and slide it over so it's at the beginning of my clip. I'll zoom in here. And now you can see when we hit play, it comes up just like that. So you can continue adding layers. You can add stickers, you can add some pictures, you can add B-roll, other footage, whatever you want, just by adding with the layers. Let's make some adjustments to the video here. We're going to go up here, and we're going to go to filter. Now you could change some of this filter look. You can make it a little darker. You could do black and white. I kind of like that one. That works pretty good for me. So now let's say we want to add some audio. So I'm going to click on the audio. Now here's an option if you want to get to the full version. There are these little crown there. Those ones are only available on the full version, okay? But there are ones that are free. So let's say I want to try City of Gray. Cool, let's do that. So we'll click plus, and now we're going to close out of that so we can see the preview. Again, we just zoom in, and now you see, now you've got this audio file down there at the bottom. It's longer than my video, so I'm just going to click on the end there again, drag that down, and there we go. Okay, now it fits in the video. So now let me preview this back. It's saying here that you could tap and hold it to go to full screen. I'm going to say I don't want to show that again. There you go. It's looking pretty sharp. Okay, now because I have a couple of videos that are in here that were shot in the vertical format, I want those to fill the screen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on that video and we're going to go up here to background. And what we can do is we can either just add a color. Or what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add this blur. So now it fills the frame with the rest of the video, but blurs it out to kind of make that nice little, you know, blended together, but filling the frame. See? And there you go. Now you even had the vertical video filling the frame. So you watch this back. It all looks good. I'm happy with this. This is the way I want the video to go. Now, one thing I do want to note is up in the top right-hand corner, you can see there's a little KineMaster logo watermark that will be embedded in the video if you're still on the free version. And that's denoted by that little crown next to it. Just like the audio files, anything with the crown means you have to have the full version to use that. If you're okay with that, then you can export it. So you can see over in the right-hand corner, all the way over on the side, the little up arrow there. We're going to click on that. And now you have your options of how you want that video to export. I'm just going to leave it as is. And you just want to go save as video. And with that, it's going to ask you, because I have that watermark, if I want to upgrade to the yearly, the monthly, or they even have a trial, depending on when you sign up for this. I'm just going to click skip. And once the video finishes exporting, then that video is yours to upload on YouTube or do whatever you want with that. It's yours to have. I hope you found this video helpful, and I will see you in the next one.